Hello, and welcome to the VSO School of Music Sinfonietta YouTube channel. My name is Mischa Gerbrecht, and today we're going to learn about percussion. Because we're in a stay-at-home situation, there are a few percussion instruments, such as the timpani or the bass drum, that I can't show you right now, either because they're too big or I just don't have them with me. But today I'll be showing you some of the common percussion instruments that I do happen to have lying around here at home. So, what is percussion? Percussion is defined as anything you can hit, or shake, or scrape. Some of the first instruments were percussion instruments, so it's quite hard to trace the origin of percussion to a specific country or place. What materials are percussion instruments made out of? Since percussion is just a general term which applies to any instrument that you can hit, shake, or scrape, there are obviously a lot of those instruments out there. But some of the main materials used are metal, wood, animal hide, plastic, glass, and rubber. One of the most common orchestral percussion instruments is the snare drum. But what I have here is called a practice pad. It has the same feel as a snare drum, but it's easier to transport, and usually a lot quieter. This is what this one sounds like. There are a lot of different types of practice pads. This one is a lot louder and a little less bouncy. This one is a lot softer, but quite bouncy. Both practice pads and snare drums are examples of unpitched percussion. Percussion that, when you hit it, it makes an indefinite pitch. Another example is this djembe drum. Or this güiro I played earlier. These instruments usually either add color, orchestral color, to a piece, or they're particularly useful for keeping the rhythm. But the instruments that get the melody are the pitched percussion instruments. This is a xylophone, and it's considered a pitched percussion instrument. This particular xylophone is called a pit xylophone, so it doesn't look like xylophones usually do. Not sure if you can see, it's a little slanted compared to me, and it's a little smaller than xylophones would usually be, but it works all the same. You might notice that it looks a little bit like a piano keyboard, and actually, did you know that the piano is considered a percussive instrument because you hit the keys even though you play the strings? Playing xylophone, or any mallet instrument, you should have a variety of mallets you can use. Right now I have two with me to demonstrate. These mallets are a lot harder for a clearer and crisper sound. These mallets are softer. They can give you a mellower sound, especially useful for maybe the lower registers. Did you know that the xylophone was originally a jazz instrument because it could be easily heard on the old wax vinyl records? Most percussionists have a stick bag, like this one here, where they can place all of their drumsticks and mallets in one place. This is quite a simple bag, but inside it you can see I have another pair of drumsticks, which are thinner and shorter than the ones I used before. I have some timpani mallets. Unfortunately, I can't show you timpani today. I have some mallets that could be used on marimba or suspended cymbal. I have some harder timpani mallets. Over here, I have a softer timpani mallet. Whoops, there it is. And back at the xylophone, you saw the two mallets I used on my xylophone as well. So yeah, we usually put them all in a stick bag. Some other common orchestral percussion instruments that I have with me today include the tambourine, the triangle, the gong or the tam-tam. By the way, it does not usually sound like that. And the cymbals. Unfortunately, today we don't have cymbals, but we have the next best thing. Finger cymbals. And there are some pretty wild, crazy instruments out there that can make some pretty awesome sounds. Like this bird call. Or this bird call. Or this slide whistle. Or this train whistle. To finish up, I'd like to play for you an excerpt on my xylophone of a piece by George Hamilton Green called Triplets. Thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope you all had fun, and I hope you all learned something. Remember to subscribe to the Sinfonietta YouTube channel, and come back every Tuesday for a new Meet the Instrument video. See you later!